everybody. It is Sunday, the last video of the week. It is almost noon, and so far so good. I am attempting a 3-day fast because I want Mia to go away. And the only way I can do that if I try not to eat at all and just stick to water, coffee, and tea. That's what I'm gonna do. I am on Twitter, and I am talking to this very lovely girl, and we're just going back and forth with our self-loathing. And now there is some guy on there, I don't know who he is, and he has just retweeted something that we've said, and I don't understand why. I don't get why people do that sometimes. I don't know if they're bored or if they genuinely like what you say, or especially this. Like, this is a total ED related conversation, and here comes a outsider to, but whatever. So anyways, and I'm chatting with the boy, and just a second. So yeah, I'm gonna attempt a 3-day fast over here. So far so good. I went to bed at like 4 a.m. I stayed online looking at Big Brother on YouTube. I was catching up on the season that I had missed. Yes, I watched Big Brother, damn it. And it's not good to go to sleep right after you watch stuff like that because you dream about it. And I had a dream about damn Big Brother. I had a dream that they evicted me out of the house because I was eating all the sunflower seeds. And so, yeah. But I did manage to get some sleep afterwards. I'm noticing that, because, you know, I'm on the clonazepam. I'm supposed to take it, one at bedtime, right? A full one. And I have them because I, sometimes they make me too drowsy. And I've been having them lately because they have been helping with the chest pains. Now, I haven't had any pains in about like 3 days, maybe. But, you know, every now and again I get that sting. What I think that was the massive dehydration from the straight up week of laxatives, I am guessing. So who knows? But I have been having the pills, right? And so I take half at night and half in the daytime. Fine. Now, I am noticing that, like, I have no recollection of taking the pill. And I'm noticing that, like, it's less pills in the bottle, you know? Like, maybe I'm, without realizing, taking more than I'm supposed to or something. I don't know. Because I could have sworn that, you know, because I usually leave something in the morning. And, like, now there's nothing, you know? And so, God, I don't get it. I don't know if I'm taking more or what, or but I have less pills now. It's time for my refill anyhow, so I don't know if I should bring that up with my shrink. I don't think I should. I don't think she would like that. That would probably concern her very much, so I'm not gonna talk to her about that. I'm trying my best. Why is this coming? Oh boy, I'm trying my best to not binge and purge today. There's nothing to binge on in this house. But like I said, I do have money. And there's a huge part of me that wants to go right now and just buy crap to binge on. And then there's the other part of me that is like, no, you know, like, don't waste the little bit of money you have left on stuff that is just gonna go. And so Like, there's something to binge on here, but I would have to, like, go to the store and get more stuff, you know? Like, it's not enough for me to binge on. Like, the way I want to binge, you know? So, that's the thing that's preventing me. I have a huge, huge, huge headache. Last night, I was trying to slow down Mia, and I couldn't. I failed miserably. And I was so drained and tired, and I almost did not work out. I got in my gear, and I was ready to go, and then I got on the machine, and then I was like, 60 calories in, and then I was like, fuck it, and sat my ass down, and just drank water, and then I was feeling dizzy, I was feeling anxious. I was feeling so tired, and then at almost 11 o'clock at night, I started to work out. And I managed to work out, even though it was really crappy workout. But at least it was something. I don't want to do that today. I want to work out earlier today. And hopefully no binging and purging. So I won't be that tired. I have a headache. I have some Motrin 800s in my medicine cabinet. But I don't know if I can take them. I don't know if they interact with, like, the other pills that I'm on, or if it's okay, or if that doesn't matter. So, I don't know. I've taken aspirin, but that doesn't really do anything. My head hurts a lot. I'm probably just dehydrated or something, so I guess a liquid fast these 3 days would be great. What else? I want to stay busy today. I'm going to do everything possible. I'm going to read today. And the irony. This book is called Hungry. And it's not about food. It's not an eating book. Although it has some food mentioned in there. It's a book that has... it's a book about six women. And it's six short stories. And it's basically the hunger of... Well, what women are hungry for, you know, love, sex, a little bit of food in there, power, you know, there's six different women, six different careers, points in their life, and so it's an interesting read. I can't wait to read that, and I will read it, damn it, because I'm trying to not cuckoo today, and also I am going to... I don't care if I have to watch every Big Brother episode from the beginning till now. I will keep busy. And today, incidentally, is crafts day for me and my kids. So I was thinking of going to get some, what do you call those things? Ugh, no, I'm forgetting crap. I have the worst memory. I am Alzheimer's in the making. My God, what do you call them? Oh, popsicle sticks. Popsicle sticks. And we're going to go and get some of those and some glue and just make a mess on the carpet with popsicle sticks and see what we can build. Because yesterday, after I got the iPod, I passed by this strip mall that I love to go to. And they have this thrift store there, and they have like bags of toys, and the bags of toys are like 95 cents or whatever. And so she found this little plastic container with like teeny tiny little animals, and so that's what she's playing with now. She loves animals. She's been playing Zoo Tycoon on the computer like nonstop, and so she's like torn between the zookeeper or the teacher. And so I think the popsicle idea is good, because she could build like little corral for the animals and stuff. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I hope I can just get the popsicle sticks and get the hell out of Dodge, because I have money and I don't want to bitch and purge. And my God, the store has so much crap that I really, really am thinking of. I am talking to the boy, and the boy's like, oh, I'm eating... What the hell was he eating? He was eating some kind of sour candy. Sour candy, I love it. And I'm like, stop it, stop telling me what are you eating and stuff. So yeah, I was talking to him yesterday. He was pretty upset from work, you know. He had to do like extra work because the people are lazy there. But then he started talking to me. He's like, thank God I talked to you, because then I calmed down. So we were talking about the iPod. And thank God for the iPod, folks, because the one thing about this that I missed is that I have Yahoo Messenger on here, so I can chat with him from bed, and I will be doing that later if I don't feel well. We were talking about the iPod, because when I was on Craigslist, I was sending him the links, and so we were back and forth with that. We were like, I was telling him, oh, do you think this is a good price, or what do you think about this, X amount of gigabytes times whatever, and so I told him, yeah, I got it, and he was like, wow, that's great, you got the thing, and he asked me the price. And so I told him how much it cost, and then he was like, damn, that was the money you were supposed to use to come up here, right? And I was like, yeah. He's like, wow. He's like, yeah, but I wish you could have came to see me and stuff. And I was like, trust me, I want to see you, but I can't. Well, not for real, I can't go up there. It's not like I can go up there by myself. I can't go stay in a hotel room somewhere and, you know, just be the week with him or something, because I have to take my kid everywhere with me, and my husband is not gonna stay with my kid for a complete week while I go and do God knows what. He has to work, and he's gonna be suspicious as hell, and he's not gonna do that. So I was telling him, yeah, you know, I'm sorry, but you know, shit happens, and let's just take it one day at a time, you know. And so he feels the same way. He's like, yeah, you know, no worries, don't worry about that. I have complete and utter faith that we will see each other sometime, and don't worry about that. In the meantime, we just, you know, continue doing what we're doing. And that's it. And so that's pretty good. I think that's a good idea. Things happen for a reason. I was not meant to go up there. And it's better sooner than later to find these things out. So, but yeah, what else can I tell you guys? It's hard. Yesterday I was purging, and I had the worst stomach cramps ever. My God, if I wasn't already doubled over from purging, I would have doubled over. I don't know why I had like these bad cramps, and like I kept having to take a break from purging and just like soothe my stomach and then go back at it. In my mind, I kept picturing like my stomach slowly like ripping at the seams and stuff, and just slowly rupturing. And so I'm like, any minute now the blood is gonna gush in the toilet bowl. But no, so I think it's good that I want to slow down now and give my body a little break, because God, me, it's kicking my ass. My hair is starting to fall out again. Oh, my teeth hurt so bad now. They're getting really, really sensitive to cold and hot. And when I chew things, I swear to God, it feels like they're slowly cracking on me. Especially the back molars, and I don't know. I keep expecting to, like, spit up teeth and shit. My fingernails are purple. That's why I've had to polish them. They're really... God, they're really purple. And, like, the nail beds are all sunken in and stuff. And it's gross. Yeah, and oh my God, my hands were healing, and now they're all just, you know, marked up with the teeth marks and stuff. So Mia is just kicking my ass. I don't know how people can choose this, the idiots that do. I mean, my God, it's a nightmare. It's a death sentence. So you have to stop. You have to not want to do that. So, yeah, I'm gonna just try to entertain myself today, entertain my kid, and not binge and purge. Tomorrow, I wanna get a hold of my case manager and see what we can do about housing. Talk to someone, see what number I am on this waiting list, something. I don't know. And then Tuesday, I just want to go and be with my shrink and just cry to her and talk to her and see what kind of positive things she has to say to me. And I have the rest of Tuesday free. I don't know what on earth I'm going to do with myself. I don't know. Things are so weird right now. I feel like I'm in a weird place. I feel like I'm very isolated, or I am isolating myself, kind of. So, it's not that I don't want to see people or talk to people. It's just that I feel like I'm on pause, you know? Like, my life is just on pause, and I have nothing whatsoever to say. Everyone is working, everyone is doing things with themselves, and here I am doing nothing, and I feel like I have nothing to contribute to the conversation. Like, why bother, you know? So, I don't know. It won't always be like that, but it's like that now. So, hopefully I could salvage next month and the rest of the year, hopefully. I'm gonna try. I'm gonna just make the most of what I have. I think I have to start doing that. Just accept that I'm not going anywhere right now, and that I just have to work with what I have. And God, just saying that makes me want to cry, because I feel like I'm rolling over, you know, like defeated. Like, I should want more, and I should strive for more, and I do, and I want more, but it's just like it's so out of reach. It always feels so out of reach, but can't do anything about that. So, what else can I tell you? God, there was something else I wanted to say. This is why I should write things down. Before I forget, Peridot, I love Peridot. I love the shit out of Peridot. Peridot is up in arms right now, really mad over the mistreatment of me this week, and I'd love you for that you care so much. I wish I can hire you as a security guard to just take these fools out. I know that you would kick some serious ass with your giant knitting needles, and you would just crochet circles around them, I'm sure. So, I wish I could run away to New Zealand and join the circus. So, what else can I tell you guys? I don't know. I'm just gonna hang in there. Not bench and perch, trying my hardest not to. And I don't care what I have to do today. I will watch all the Big Brother episodes from the beginning if I have to. I will read books. I will build a skyscraper out of popsicles. I will do anything to not binge and purge. I am so tired of that. It's exhausting and it's disgusting. And I don't know why it's so hard to stop. God, so. But you have to stop. That's the point. I mean, it's not helpful. It's not getting you anywhere. And so yeah, I'm sure I had something else to say. I can't remember it now, and I'm gonna probably remember it later and be like, shit. So I don't know. I don't remember. My God, I forget. Oh well, must have not been important. So wish me luck on my fast, and I hope the rest of you will have a great week, and I'll try to blog tomorrow, if not Tuesday, and let's try to be safe this weekend and go easy on ourselves and not indulge in behaviors that are really harmful if we can. So let's try even just a little teeny tiny bit. So yeah, so I'm gonna go and continue the fight. So I'll talk to you guys again next week. Bye.